In a message to men and women religious, Pope Francis said, "I want to say one word to you, and this word is joy. Wherever consecrated people are, there is always joy." And from my experience at Catholic Extension, I couldn't agree more. Beyond the joy that they bring, they are doing the heavy lifting by building the future of our church. I would like to share with you the story of three such women religious who show that through our faith, we are always more than our circumstances.
I'm Sister Fatima Santiago.
I am Emily Jackson.
I'm Sister Carolyn Kossip. We have real mission territory here in the traditional sense. We have people living way below the poverty line, struggling in their everyday life. And this is a place that we belong as missionaries.
This may be on the map as America, the United States, a first world country, but the Rio Grande Valley is definitely not that.
Colonias in my diocese would be families that are settling quickly and building their own homes and living them very poor conditions, oftentimes with incomplete roofs and floors that are in process of being put in, for families that are just arriving from all over Latin America. Many of them are undocumented, and yet trying to find a way to establish a life.
There is an emphasis on preferential love for the poor. And so where there is a place where there's a need and nobody wants to go, that's where you find the ICM sister.
All the programs that we started here started from the needs of the people.
Because of the programs we have here, our people know one another, they interact with one another, and this center has become a second home for many of them.
You come into the Proyecto building and you see all these things happening. I mean, there's an area where the children are learning, there's a Head Start program, there's an area for medical needs. It's something that is so unique. But yet, it's something that I would never expect anything else from these beautiful sisters.
I could see that the people are very strong in their faith.
So we said, well, it's obvious. We have a faith community. It just needs a home.
So that is where the need came to have a church.
So now this is their place that means so much to them because they're all raised as Catholics in Mexico, and they were really lost sheep until we had a Catholic church here for them, the center of their faith life.
The Catholic Church presence makes them happy and transformative, and they go out, reach out, and they form communities.
Para mí, estar esta iglesia, este centro comunitario, estar estas hermanas aquí con nosotros en esta comunidad, es tener la presencia de Dios con nosotros.
They said, we know you are here, you are sisters, we are Catholics, we are back.
The work of these missionary sisters really does shine the light of Christ on Pueblo de Pamas. The sisters truly embody the mission of Catholic Extension and the directive of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, who is urging all of us to go to the margins of our society, to work with the poor, to share our gifts and spread the joy of the gospel.
Now we have people in the Proyecto that are talking about having their kids go to college and having their kids expand their horizons, and you know, that there is hope.
This is the important word, vision. They have it. They know. They live here. They hear from the residents of this area every day.
It's came to bond and bring families closer to each other and bring God closer to all of us. And I think it has made a difference.
The Valley's the Hispanic population is naturally been Catholic for a long time. And I think, you know, we're just kind of bringing them back home.
It was an obvious thing to nominate the sisters who really have been the glue that has made that community possible.
for all that they have done for the people they so humbly serve, and for their boundless faith and dedication. Catholic Extension has presented the Missionary Sisters of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, Sister Carolyn, Sister Emily, and Sister Fatima, from the Diocese of Brownsville, Texas, with our highest honor, the Lumen Christi Award.
The light of Christ has to reach everybody.
I would pray for the mission of Catholic Extension, that it continues to help other organizations like us to further God's kingdom of love and peace and justice.
Please join me today in thanking God for these selfless women religious, the Missionary Sisters of the Immaculate Heart of Mary.
All we can do is use the words of our Blessed Mother. The Lord has done great things in us. Blessed be His name.
Amazing, isn't it? Women religious continue to do the vital work of empowering people, building community, and reaching the marginalized. The sisters, funded by Catholic Extension, are committed to training the lay leaders who will carry on the essential ministries of the church. In the last 5 years alone, Catholic Extension has provided nearly $7 million to support the work of women religious in 48 U.S. dioceses. To learn more about their work and how you can support them, you can go to our website, catholicextension.org.